Hello, so today we're going to be stringing and pruning the indoor hydroponic tomatoes. If you're wondering how we got them to this point, we made an entire video of us setting them up. We haven't watered them since setting them up. We're at about the 3-week point. We're going to let the roots grow a little deeper in the bucket before we watered them. We started them at 1 EC. I want to show you guys the roots because once we string them up, we aren't going to be able to check the roots again. So tomatoes have two kinds of leaves, sun leaves and suckers. The suckers grow in between the main stem and the sun leaves. So we're going to be taking off all suckers because we are trying to keep them to one main stem. There's several tomato plants in each bucket, so I don't want them to get overcrowded. Also, I don't want them to try and create an entire another tomato plant, and I want them to focus on flowering and collecting sunlight. So we're just going to keep them to one main stem and prune off all suckers as they grow. We have some indeterminate and determinate varieties here. We have tomato black cherry, large red cherry tomato, Roma tomato, and Floridade tomato. So when you string them up, we tie them underneath the two bottom nodes and then up to the top bar, and we wrap it around a little bit. So on this one, we tore off all the suckers, and we're waiting at the top here because we can't tell completely what's going on yet. And as that grows, we'll wait and see. And if there's a sucker, we'll take it off. We just don't want to take that off yet until we see that grow and develop, or until it gets to a certain height, because we can only go so tall in here. So at a certain height, we are going to chop them and stop them from growing taller. So I've had tomatoes can live 2 to 5 years, and I've had two tomato plants live 2 years long and produce throughout the whole way. But one of them I did not prune, and I let it get to 11 feet tall and 6 feet wide, thinking that it would make a bunch of tomatoes. And it really didn't, because there was not many environmental stressors making it flower. So tomatoes are day neutral, and they don't really care what light schedule they get to flower. So since I don't change the light schedule or the temperature, they think it's the same time of year all year round. So without some sort of environmental stressor like cold or drought, they don't have as much as a signal to flower. So pruning can help with that. But we already have some clusters of flowers on here that I want to show you guys up top here. So like I said, we're about at the 3-week point. So we can remove sun leaves that aren't getting good light as well. Tomatoes are really easy to clone. If you've ever seen them have little white bumps on them, that's them trying to essentially take root if there was enough moisture there. So you can take a sucker and throw it in some water and have an entire another tomato plant. If it starts to droop, just take some leaves and clip them because it's having trouble hydrating. But this could be an entire another tomato black cherry. So I use reverse osmosis filtered water, but you could use some tap water. I've tried that with some strawberries and it's worked fine. So that's a sucker that is big enough to clone. Some of these other suckers that I'm taking off right now are still underdeveloped enough to the point where they are probably not large enough to clone. This one is very overcrowded and has almost 6 tomato plants in it. So I might have to take an entire tomato plant out of here due to overcrowding. And that may leave some dead roots in the bucket, but I use HydroGuard, so that should help decompose and break down those dead roots into something the other roots can eat. So I've shown the nutrient bundle, and I'll have a link down below to all the gear I use. And if you hover over the bottom portion, you can see a small description of what I use each product for. And I've, in previous videos, shown and described all the products in pretty great detail. So if you have any questions, in my hydroponic plants playlist, there's more specific videos, or like I said, we put out an entire video of us setting up these up until this point. All right, so to be honest, I probably would recommend only 1 or 2 tomato plants per bucket, but some of these have 4, this one has 3, this one has 6, and this one has 5. So like I was saying, you can cut one out. I should have done it sooner, and it will obviously cause less dead roots in there. And I could have, from the start, only put one or two in there. But you could also just stunt them if you don't want like to kill it off at this point and have like a little bit of root death in there. So I could just come in there and chop this one at the top that I would have taken out and severely disadvantage it to the rest of them and keep it stunted in the bucket so that it doesn't grow any new roots and doesn't really get much stronger and also doesn't really die off, which is what I do sometimes with some of my plants.
Here's a great example of what I'm talking about. I just wanted to include a clip of this. This is a pepper that is actually the same age as this 11-month-old pepper that I just left in the bucket. I didn't want to kill, and it's just been stunted there this whole time. And yeah, it doesn't like take up too much water to leave it. And so that's sometimes what I'll do, but you don't have to.
You can see there's actually no light getting on it. So when I remove it, you won't even really be able to tell the difference if that was removed. So I don't really want the plant wasting energy on this branch. And I want to grow new branches that get good light. So we're just going to end up defoliating them and making them all find a way to live and work with each other in harmony. And that might shorten the yields on some of them, but we'll just make it up on the other ones in space, if that makes sense. We're going to maximize the amount of space we can possibly try and grow them in. But yeah, like I said, I would probably only recommend one or two if you were going to do it, because it'd be probably easier to manage and less messy and maybe more successful. But I like to try and push the limit. To string them up, I put three ropes about 6 to 8 inches across so that we could get like three layers. As they continue to grow, we can use these little twisty ties as they grow and wrap them around as a little loop. Or you could use string or keep wrapping it around as it grows like that. Whatever you want to do. But these little twisty ties work nice. You can clone off a sun leaf too. Same thing, just stick it in water or a rock wool cube and then just trim the leaves if it starts to droop. I went through and defoliated about this much so far. You don't have to take off a whole sun leaf when you're defoliating. That isn't going to get good light. Like for example, down here, I just want to take off some of these that aren't going to get good light. But over on the end of it, it still is. So obviously that's because they're overcrowded and competing with each other a little bit. So those are a little bit of sacrifices we're going to make and go through and just try and make sure we can get some better light. Something like this one, for example, too. I don't want to take off this whole branch, but it is hitting the wall and the tip of it is essentially useless. So I just want to go in there and cut off the top of it that's not gonna get a good light, and that leaf that's just hitting into the wall. So that's all I think I'm gonna prune and defoliate today. We added an extra light because these are 2-foot flower coverage and we have about 6 feet of tomatoes here. We'll check back up again when we go to water them at around the 4 or 5 week point. For now, if you want, we have our hydroponic plants playlist on YouTube or Facebook. What YouTube thinks is best for you, or you could subscribe for more. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.